Hi, I'm Rongji. In the next few minutes, I will guide you on how to perform a 5GNR 4x4 MIMO test by using the XApps 5GNR measurement application. So before we jump into the live demo, let's first get our PXI tracy or set with the modules we've got listed here. We'll require 4 transceiver modules. In this case, I'm using M9416A model, so which internally integrates both signal generator and the signal analyzer. After that, you need to prepare the reference signal waveform. You can use PulseWave signal generation desktop software with valid license to generate the 5GNR MIMO waveforms. I've dropped a link in the description box that will guide you on generating the 5GNR MIMO signal by using the PWSG desktop software. So check it out. We've got 5 simple steps to narrow this MIMO measurement. Now, let's get started. The first step is to launch the modular instruments. Before launching the modular TRX application, you should make sure that MIMO function is enabled. If your modular TRX application is launched in normal mode previously, these steps are required for MIMO measurement. Or if you are already in MIMO mode, you can skip this and go ahead. Alright, let's run Launch Modular TRX as administrator here. You'll see the VXT we've installed popping up on the screen. Let's select slot 8, 13, 4, and 17, then press Run Selected button here. You will see 4 XApps instances are initializing and preloading the measurement applications. Alright, let's dive into the source configuration part. First, let's recall MIMO waveforms. So, in the slot 4 XApps, let's click on the main tab to open up the measurement view select screen, select the 5GNR mode, modulation analysis, then press OK. In the 5GNR measurement, click on the system button here, press Show System. Please make sure that you have a valid MIMO license as well as license for the 5GNR analyzer and the signal source. Alright, we'll navigate to Input-Output menu. Set the IF power to -10 dBm. Then select ARB Setup, click on Select Waveform. Then press Record Waveform. Choose the waveform we prepared before and press Record to import the waveform to the ARB memory. In the ARB segment, select the record waveform, press OK. After that, turn on ARB State. Next, let's adjust the center frequency to 3.5 GHz. Finally, remember to active IF port to playback the signal. Next, let's dive into the MIMO configuration of the signal source part. Click on Source Sync. Select the 4x4 option here and set sync type as primary. Next, click on the sync settings here. On the source sync settings page, let's active the other 3 modules and turn on sync settings switch. Finally, navigate back and turn on sync start. Alright, we are ready to proceed with the configuration of the analyzers part. So firstly, let's establish MIMO settings for the analyzers. So first, let's go to Mass Setup menu here. Within it, navigate to the radio tab. Here, you need to modify the link direction to uplink. Next, let's click on Multi-Channel Config button here. On this Multi-Channel Configuration page, you'll find a list of detected slot information here. Input the correct instrument port value and enable each channel. After that, turn on the MIMO function. Now we are ready to configure the modulation settings. To do this, let's press Record button here. Next, navigate the Mode Info tab, select CC Setup here, press the Record From button, and choose the modulation file which was exported from the signal generation software. So press Record button here. All the demodulation settings will be automatically configured for you. Now you can see the MIMO signal has been successfully demodulated. If you want to see the constellation diagram results of the other layers, simply adjust the layer number accordingly. The same procedure applies if you want to inspect the results of the spectrum, detected allocation, and the roaming time traces of other layers. So moreover, the error summary table here provides you the MIMO TAE results. XApp also provides you a quick way to review MIMO results. To do this, let's navigate to Display menu here, select the View tab, and click on MIMO Summary. This will present a user summary for each channel, including results such as modulation, EVM results, and the MIMO info table here provides you more detailed TAE results for each channel. Additionally, if you go to normal 3x3 view, XApps also provides you 3D trace results, including RE power and error vector. So to learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at this website. Thank you for watching.